A few minutes ago, President Obama gave his speech to the United Nations, and he expressed two main goals for United States foreign policy going forward. One was Iran's pursuit of nuclear weapons, and the other was seeking peace between Israelis and Palestinians. So those are the, he's now expressed two main goals for U.S. diplomacy.
He wants to resolve the issue with Iran's nuclear program. And later, your president is going to address the United Nations. And so we're asking our callers like you, if you could stand at the United Nations, what would you tell the world?
I would tell that maybe we're very peaceful people, and we love all people, especially for myself. I said that I love everybody, and I want every country to be friend. And you know, from when the revolution happened in Iran, I was just 7, and all during, now I'm 42, and all the long years I was just thinking that, I was wondering why we are not friends with America. I really don't know, and I love to be friends with every country.
As President Obama said, that was the last time the United States had relations with Iran. Was not since 1979. Now he has said that he's directing Secretary of State John Kerry to work with the European Union and other countries to seek an agreement, a meaningful agreement with Iran over the nuclear issue. And it sounds like there may be some opportunities now with your new president, Rouhani. What do you think? Do you think the time, do from what you're hearing in the Iranian news, could this be a good time for better relations?
I think so. Everybody here in Iran are very happy to have President Rouhani. And we are very hopeful that he can do something for the people, for Iranian people. Because of the sanctions, we have very pressure, you know, a lot of pressure on people, especially, for example, in hospital, we don't have enough drug. In aircraft, we don't have the mechanical, I don't know, the special tools for aircraft, you know? Mm-hmm. And lots of the factories now are closed because they don't have the primary stuff to do it, to do their job because of the sanction.
How do you think the countries should be working together on the issue of Iran's nuclear program?
I hope all of the problems in the future will be solved. I don't know, the problems are very, very simple to be solved. We Iranians like you Americans, and I think you Americans are like we Iranians. This is the problems government, and I think that isn't very, very, very difficult to solve.
You know, it's interesting, like you're saying that the problems between Iran and the United States are very simple to solve. So if you could give your ideas to the world, how would you solve what you think is a simple problem? What are some of the basic steps to resolving this?
I think we have to connect with government of America more than before, and we have to speak and about our problems that we have common problems, and that we have in Asia and or other religions, other regions. So that I think that's simple to be solved.
And for the United States, what would you recommend that our government do?
I think our president Ayatollah Rouhani can solve the problems, and but now in our country, I think in the future will be good for us, and I think it doesn't matter. But we Iranians, people of Iran, like to connect with America.
Mm-hmm. So we're asking our callers, if you could speak to the United Nations, if you could speak to the world, what message would you like to send?
Okay, thank you for accepting my call. My message for those who attend this meeting, I just want to speak about the security of the country, because we need to peace and security. Afghan people pass 3 decades war. They need to peace. I just want from Obama and the other people who are authorized to help to Afghan poor people. This is my message just for them.
Do you feel, you know, as the world shifts, changes its focus to other crises, Syria, Iran's nuclear program, do you feel like Afghanistan is receiving enough attention from the world?
Yeah, I think from all worlds, people and presidents, that they, their attention is on Afghanistan. We are pleased from them. But our enemies, I think, Iran and Pakistan, they don't want us to live in a security place. So I don't like Pakistan and Iran because they don't want to live in a security. They sent Taliban to us to bomb a site and kill our people, innocent people.
So you feel like Afghanistan's receiving attention from Iran and Pakistan, but an unwanted attention?
Are you worried about next year with the Western forces pulling out? I know Canada is scheduled to pull out by the end of March, this coming March. The United States by later in the year. Are you worried about that?
Actually, I'm worried about that because I'm a student. I will graduate this year from school. If the United Nations security or forces out from Afghanistan, I'm worried about, because Taliban will get government again if the international community went from Afghanistan.
Is this an issue that you talk to your family and friends a lot about? I mean, how are you preparing for this?
Yeah, actually, my classmates, my maths, my teachers, usually talk every day about this when, well, on 2014, the international community will go from Afghanistan. All people, all Afghans worry about that,
mm-hmm.
actually, because in some provinces, Taliban took control.
Mm-hmm.
And just in Kabul, we have a little bit security, not in all country, across the country. We don't have any good security across the country. We just have a little bit security in Kabul.
If you were had a chance to speak to the world leaders at the UN, what would your message be as an Iraqi?
We are from Iraqi. The message is don't use the strength in series. Don't I didn't like war because we tried the war in Iraq and it is not good.
So you say we tried war in Iraq and it's not good. It didn't
yes.
The
yes.
result
the
you
war,
don't feel was worth
war
the
create a problem.
It so
is
it
a
should
lot
be...
of people die in Iraq. It is create or make the violence. The violence in Iraq, it is before the war.
If you could stand up in front of the United Nations, what uh-huh. would you want to tell the world?
Okay, first of all, I wouldn't like the war happen in the world. Just like, you know, in Egypt, the accidents happen, and I'm real sorry about this. And also, I would like to help, to be able to help the refugees all over the world, because, you know, if you are healthy, if you have enough wealth, you should help the people who are poor and who have, I also would like to help the people who have such mentally disabled people or physically disabled people. And that's it, I think.
I wish every people in the world maybe were pierced and never have tourism, and maybe people live together, together, and maybe pierce stay behind in the leaf, and hope we have a bright and future.
So you wish everyone in the world peace, and that there's no terrorism, and that we all have a bright future. That sounds that sounds really good. What proposal or what would you suggest we do on an individual level and a country level to encourage peace?
Yes, yes. Maybe president or prime minister pay more attention about the living of people. Take care about infrastructure, about transportation and education, especially education. And hopefully any every people can reach the education to lift the high living.
And for nowadays, it's important thing for solve the problem with Bashar al-Assad in Syria, because they kill children and kill women and old people. And we hope Mr. Ban Ki-moon can, he's a weather man, and he can, wiseman, and we also we hope to better. I don't know, but I'm
okay,
not.
That's great. Thank you so much.